السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. الحمد لله رب العالمين وأصلي وأسلم على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. ما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله، خير الهدي هدي نبينا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار. Brothers, sisters, I like to clarify in this video, inshallah, few minutes. After the course I did two days back, many brothers and sisters asked the same question, which madhab your salah? Okay, you will teach us the salah according to which madhab? Is it Hanafi? They mean, is it Hanafi, Shafi'i, Maliki, Hanbali? What is the madhab? I like to clarify or to read some of the points from the book of Shaykh al-Albani, rahimahullah ta'ala. Of course, this is very important and very good book to learn how to perform the salah according to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam. Okay, so before talking in his book, Shaykh al-Albani, rahimahullah, before talking about the salah, before describing the way of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam in performing the salah, he said, okay, and he mentioned, he put a chapter, أقوال الأئمة في اتباع السنة وترك الأقوال المخالفة لها. He put the chapter, the sayings of the scholars, he means the four scholars, great scholars, in following the Sunnah and to leave their opinions if they oppose the Sunnah of Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم. طيب, he mentioned number one, الإمام أبو حنيفة رحمه الله تعالى. He said some of the sayings of Imam Abu Hanifa from the books of Al-Ahnaf. One of them, إِذَا صَحَّ الْحَدِيثِ فَهُوَ مَذْهَبِي. If the hadith is authentic, then it is my madhab. Imam Abu Hanifa rahimahullah said, if the hadith is authentic, then this is my madhab. Also, another saying, لَا, it is not allowed for anyone to take our opinion without knowing what is the source. Okay, without knowing what is the source. Also, in another narration, he said, Imam Abu Hanifa rahimahullah ta'ala, it is forbidden for the one who doesn't know my evidence, who doesn't know my proof, to give a fatwa according to my saying. Also, he said, I am a human being. We say something today and we leave it tomorrow. Subhanallah. And also, he said to his student, one of the famous students of Imam Abu Hanifa, Abu Yusuf. His name is Abu Yusuf. It is famous. Al-Qadi Abu Yusuf, the judge Abu Yusuf, Yaqub. He said, Abu Hanifa said to his student, don't write everything that you hear from me. I see something today and I leave it tomorrow. It means I follow something today and I leave it tomorrow. And I see something tomorrow and I leave it after tomorrow. He means the opinions. And also he said, Imam Abu Hanifa rahimahullah, if I say anything which opposes the Quran and the Sunnah, then leave my saying, leave my opinion. Okay, so this is Imam Abu Hanifa rahimahullah ta'ala. Then Shaykh al-Albani rahimahullah mentioned the sayings from Imam Malik. Imam Malik said, I am a human being. I say right and I say wrong. Okay, so check my opinions. Whatever goes with the Quran and Sunnah, take it and follow it. And if you notice anything doesn't go with the Quran and Sunnah, leave it. Okay? Also, Imam Malik said, it is not allowed for anyone. Okay, it is not allowed for anyone after the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam to take his opinion from, except him sallallahu alayhi wasallam. He means it is not allowed to take the opinion of anyone after the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, except the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam. And he mentioned, rahimahullah al-Albani, one narration about Imam Malik. Ibn Wahb, one of the students of Imam Malik, said, I hear Imam Malik, rahimahullah, and he was asked about takhlil al-asabi'. It means to to wash in the ablution and the wudu in between the fingers, the fingers of the feet. Then Imam Malik said, no need for that. ليس ذلك على الناس. It is not on people to do that. Then Ibn Wahb said, I waited until people left the masjid or left Imam Malik. Then I went to Imam Malik and I said, oh Imam, I have sunnah about washing in between the fingers of the feet. Then Imam said, what is the sunnah? What do you mean? Which hadith? He said, Al-Layth ibn Sa'd, sorry, I heard Al-Layth ibn Sa'd, Ibn Lahi'a, Amr ibn al-Harith, and Amr ibn al-Harith from Yazid ibn Amr al-Mu'afiri, from Abi Abd al-Rahman al-Hubali, from Al-Mustawr ibn Shaddad al-Qurashi, radiallahu anhu, he said, I saw Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam washing in between the toes by his little finger. Okay, then Imam Malik said, wallahi, this is a good hadith. This is a sound hadith. Then after that, when people ask Imam Malik about washing in between the fingers, he was telling them about this sunnah. So immediately Imam Malik, rahimahullah, changed his position when he heard the hadith. Number three, Imam Shafi'i, rahimahullah ta'ala. Imam Shafi'i, okay, said, ما من أحد إلا وتتبع عليه سنة. Anyone will miss one sunnah. He means you cannot find a man who knows all the ahadith. Okay? So whatever I say about the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, whatever I say, okay, and you find something from the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam different than my opinion, so the correct opinion or the correct thing is to take the hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Then he mentioned a saying from Imam Shafi'i. This is very important, brothers and sisters. Imam Shafi'i said, all the Muslims agreed upon that if the sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is clear for anyone, then it is not allowed for you to leave the sunnah. This is ijma', brothers and sisters. Imam Shafi'i rahimahullah said, if you know a hadith, authentic hadith, okay, then it is not allowed for you to ignore this hadith, to leave this hadith, and you follow the opinion of other scholars. Okay, so this is very important saying from Imam Shafi'i rahimahullah. Also, Sheikh Al-Alban mentioned about Shafi'i rahimahullah, if you find in my book anything different than the sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, then you should say and you should follow the sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and you should leave what I have said. Okay, and also he said something like Imam Abu Hanifa. And Imam Shafi'i also said, إِذَا صَحَّ الْحَدِيثِ فَهُوَ مَذْهَبِي. If the hadith is authentic, then it is my madhab. Okay, so if you ask, what is the madhab of Imam Shafi'i? You say, the madhab of Imam Shafi'i is the sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Also, he said to Imam Ahmed, rahimahullah, because Imam Shafi'i is the teacher of Imam Ahmed, or one of the teachers of Imam Ahmed. So he said to Imam Ahmed, it was known that Imam Ahmed is a scholar of hadith, and also a scholar of fiqh, a scholar of aqidah. But it was known among the four Imam that Imam Ahmed had more hadith more than the other scholars. So Imam Shafi'i said to Imam Ahmed, you know hadith more than me. You know hadith and you know the narrators more than me. So if the hadith is authentic, then tell me please. فَعْلِمُونِ بِهِ. Even the hadith is from Al-Kufa or it is from Al-Basra or it is from Al-Sham. Okay, these are areas. Okay. Yeah, please tell me. حَتَّى أَذْهَبَ إِلَيْهِ إِذَا كَانَ صَحِيحًا. Please tell me, then I should follow that hadith if it is authentic. Also, Imam Shafi'i rahimahullah said, any issue in fiqh, if the hadith is authentic from Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and with the scholars of this field, and it is not like what I said, then I regret and I will follow, I'm following the hadith in my life and also after my death. Also, Imam Shafi'i rahimahullah said, if you notice me that I say something and there is authentic hadith from the Prophet ﷺ different than what I said, then you should know that I am mad, I am crazy. Khalas, my brain gone. Also Shafi'i rahimahullah, anything I say and you find something from the Sunnah of Rasulullah ﷺ different than what I said, then you should follow. Then the priority is for the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So don't imitate me. And the last thing from Imam Shafi'i rahimahullah, any hadith from the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, then you should know that it is my opinion, it is my saying, it is my madhab. Any hadith, even if you did not hear it from me, I did not write this hadith, I did not say this hadith, but you know that this hadith is authentic hadith from the Prophet ﷺ, then you should know this is my opinion. And the last one is Imam Ahmed bin Hanbal rahimahullah ta'ala. Imam Ahmed rahimahullah said, لا تقلدني. He said to one of his students, don't imitate me, don't imitate Imam Malik, don't imitate Imam Shafi'i, don't imitate Imam Al-Awza'i, don't imitate Imam Thawri, and take from the same source that they have taken from. It means take from the Sunnah, because all of these scholars took from the Sunnah, so you should take from the Sunnah. Also, Imam Ahmed rahimahullah said, the opinion of Al-Awza'i, the opinion of Malik, the opinion of Abu Hanifa, all of these things are opinions. And all of them the same for me. And the issue is with the athar, it means with the hadith and with the narrations of the companions radiyallahu ta'ala anhum. And also one of the sayings of Imam Ahmad rahimahullah, he said, and this is very serious, من رد حديث رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم هو على شفا هلك. The one who rejects the hadith of Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم, then he is standing on an edge. It means if he's going to fall in Jahannam والعياذ بالله. طيب, so these are some of the sayings of الإمام, of the four imam. So the answer now for the question, which madhab? Okay, so I answered during that class. The way is the way of the whole madhab, the four madhab, because all the madhab, I mean Abu Hanifa, Malik, Shafi'i, Ahmed, rahmatullah alayhim, all of them followed the same madhab, which is following the sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Yes, now if you open the books, you will find differences. Okay, but what is the concept? If the hadith is authentic, then you have to follow the hadith and you ignore the opinion if it doesn't go with the hadith. Okay, so this is one point, and please, if you like, you can read the introduction of the book of Shaykh Al-Albani rahimahullah, Sifat Salat al-Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The second point that I like to mention two points, so already I mentioned one. The second point I like to mention, also many questions about the differences between the man and woman in the salah. Please Sheikh mention the 57 differences between the man and woman in the salah. Okay, we should know also that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam did not mention the differences between the man and woman in the salah. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam gave a general concept, which is sallu kama ra'aytumuni usalli. صَلُّوا كَمَا رَأَيْتُمُونِ يُصَلِّي. Pray as you have seen me pray. He did not say this only for the men or only for the women. He said this for the Muslims. So brothers, sisters, how should we pray? We should pray like the Prophet ﷺ. You are a man, you are a woman, you are a young boy, younger. You have to follow, you have to follow, and you have to do your best to follow the Prophet ﷺ in his way. Yes, the scholars mentioned some differences, but there is no proof from the authentic Sunnah that the man should do this way and the woman should do that way. Yes, there is something according to the conditions before the Salah, like covering the body. Okay, of course this is an authentic difference between the man and woman. Okay, the covering of the man in the salah is different than the covering of the woman in the salah. طيب, and all, يعني also, I mean, these are outside the salah. Also, the man has to pray in the masjid, but the woman has not to pray in the masjid. It's better for her to pray at home. But as points, okay, number one, number two, number three, number 20, number 50, or as one of the brothers mentioned, 57, we need a proof. We need a proof or evidence from the Quran or authentic Sunnah that this is a difference between the man and the woman. This is the man or the woman. I mentioned only one point that, yani, if the woman is outside, praying outside, yeah, for example, in the haram, okay, or she's in the malls or in the market and there's no prayer room, she's praying outside, okay, yani, maybe this point that we tell the woman, don't open your arms, okay, elbows, why? Because this will expose maybe your body for the men, according to your dress. Okay, this is not mentioned as a hadith, but as a general concept that the woman should not expose the size of her body. Okay, the size of her body. So these two points that I like to clarify, Taib, and some brothers and sisters ask about the video. Yani, sorry, the video was not okay from my Instagram, but it was nice from the Instagram of Brother Fatih. So if you like, you can check Fatih Safarajik. You can find, inshallah, the video in his Instagram, or you can check the Lajna Hidayah, Hidayah Kuwait Instagram. You can find, inshallah, the lecture. And also, inshallah, now we are working in editing the video because we used two cameras. We are editing now the video, so maybe we need about 2 weeks to show you, inshallah, in a nice video.